day everyone. Today's video is a short overview of urea cycle presented by Rana Zahrani. To start the urea cycle, we need to know first why do we form urea in our body. So, our bodies need to get rid of excess nitrogen since it is toxic to our bodies, and this is mainly by three ways or forms in animals and humans. As you can see here, these are the three excess nitrogen forms. First one, which is in a form of ammonia and ammonium ions, which is, for example, in fish, these are water soluble, which makes them easily diffused in water. Second one is in a form of uric acid, for example, in birds, this is a water insoluble. The third way or the third form, which is our main concern here, is in a urea form. This is in humans and it has some characteristic. It is water soluble, so it can move easily in the blood, and this is will help us in the urea cycle. On the other hand, urea is non-toxic to our bodies, which helps our bodies to get rid of excess ammonium in the urea cycle that occurs in the liver. So, ammonium will move through the blood carried by glutamate and glutamine to the liver, and then it will form urea there. After that, it will move through the blood to the kidney to be excreted in urine. First of all, the urea cycle is about 5 steps that happen in the liver. 2 of them are in the mitochondrial matrix, and the left 3 of them will be in the cytosol. To start, the first step is when the excess ammonium reaches the liver, carried by glutamate or glutamine, combined with the carbon dioxide that comes from the bicarbonate. This is will occur by the help of enzyme called carbamyl phosphate synthetase, or CBS1, and needs 2 ATP to be completed and give us the molecule called carbamyl phosphate, or CB. Then the second step is when the CB will combine with the ornithine that is transported into the matrix by this protein transporter, which called ornithine transporter. These two will be combined by enzyme called ornithine tricarboxylase, or OTC, to give us citrulline. After that, the citrulline will be transported from the mitochondria matrix into the cytosol by transporter or citrulline transporters. In the cytosol, the third step will happen when the citrulline combined with aspartate by enzyme called arginine succinate synthetase, or ASS. This is will give us arginine succinate, and then by another enzyme called arginine succinase will give us two things: fumarate and left with arginine. Let's talk about fumarate. This fumarate will go into the TCA cycle and give us 1 NADH that equals about 2.5 ATP. This ATP is which will be used in the first step to start this urea cycle, since we need energy to begin with this cycle. And the arginine, by enzyme called arginase, will give us the urea and ornithine. And this ornithine that will be get transported into the matrix to complete the second step in the urea cycle. In summary, urea cycle is 5 steps that happen in the liver. 2 of them are in the mitochondria of the liver, and three of them are in the cytosol of the liver. First step is when the excess ammonium reach the liver and combined with the carbon dioxide with the help of enzyme called CBS1 that need 2 ATP to work. And this is very important enzyme in this urea cycle because it's the first step to happen or to begin the urea cycle, and it is the rate limiting step in the cycle. This will give us the carbamyl phosphate. Carbamyl phosphate will be combined with ornithine that will be transported into the mitochondria through transporter or ornithine transporters by enzyme called OTC. This will give us the citrulline. Citrulline will be transported into the cytosol through transporter and combined with the aspartate. with the enzyme called ASS to give us arginine succinate. Arginine succinate by AS will give us arginine and fumarate. Fumarate will go to the TCA cycle to give us the 2 ATP that we will need it to start the rate limiting step that I mentioned at the beginning. And arginine by enzyme called arginase will give us the urea, the end result that we wanted, and the arginine that will go to the second step to give us the citrulline. After forming the urea in the liver, it will be transported through the blood to the kidney to be excreted as or in the urine, and also the urea can be excreted as sweat.